Very nice. That is your picture that you sent me via email.
Yep.
Okay, now I take it and I put it into AutoCAD. And then I take that picture and I draw. I just compare, keep drawing until I get what I want.
Now, is it point to point, pixel to pixel, you're drawing?
I'm drawing by lines, lines and arcs. So I take a line command, and then I'll go here, enter the line, and then I'll take an arc, and I'll do the horse's leg here.
Ah, yes.
And then once I get going, then I go through and I'll retweak, I'll move things around.
Yep.
And I try to get spacing enough so when I cut that nothing will fall out, and I got to figure out what stays and what goes.
Yeah.
So, but you did that already, that work on your picture.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, I recreate exactly what you got because you already gave me all my spacings.
Mm-hmm.
So that was easy to do.
Mm-hmm.
But the only problem I think we may have is right here.
Yeah, I kind of figured.
But we'll see what happens.
It's tight.
Then I just made this as a background. I didn't want a regular rectangular thing because everything
beautiful.
Else is... So I've made it like this, and then you're going to tell me if you want holes on the sides or on top, and we'll drill those in after.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's perfect.
Then we take it into here, and then I put it into another software. I'll just put it in quickly here. Under Joel. Apocalypse. And then I take your file from the AutoCAD.
Yeah.
And then it reads it. And then I go into my sheet. And I put it into the machine to cut. Now it's ready to go.
Excellent.
Now we'll go over to the machine and get her set up. And
so this computer is hooked up to your machine?
Yes, it is.
Yep. Here we are.
All the work at the desk. Now we're at the machine. There's your file that I put into the other program. The machine mm-hmm. recognizes it. Now I'll set up all the speeds to cut 3/16 plate.
There's a lot of marks, isn't there?
Oh, yes. Now I'm send it to here. Now I'm going to have to square off the plate and let it know the machine where I want it to start to cut.
Okay.
Set 1 point to zero.
Yep.
I'll bring it up to here, and this will give me the angle where the plate is sitting on the machine. The plate could be at a 45, it doesn't matter, it'll cut it to where mm-hmm. it's clear. Now it's set, now just reading everything and calculating for the torch kerf, it's called, for
yep.
the distance, the flame width.
Now, do you have a cut in and a cut out?
Yes. A lead in and
yeah, a lead, that's it. Lead
yeah.
in and lead out?
Yes. I'll show you that in a second.
This
now,
is
I got
cold.
A lot of plate left over, so I'm going to give it some time. Some grace period, as I call it. Check it before we cut, especially the red beans. See right here, we got one problem. I'm gonna have to go back and fix this. See the dark line?
Yeah.
Is the program drawn. The red line is with the kerf compensation. Well, the flame will go here and stop here and come back, so we won't be cutting this.
I see,
so
yeah.
So I gotta go fix the O. Check the horses. All the chains look good. Oh, your scales look good. That looks good. And the rest looks good. So I just got to go and fix
okay.
that one. So we'll stop it right here. Eat that and we'll go fix it.
Now the main computer is over here in his office. So we'll, that's where we're heading. Young man, he moves fast.
Drawing in.
That's all right.
That, but I think,
close enough.
I think you'll be okay. Now I'll save it. Now I gotta reprogram this one. Now you get to see step by step everything.
Computers are absolutely amazing, aren't they?
They are. I love them. I've done this a couple of times. Okay, return. Oops. We need the other part too. Because you want to mount it on your wall.
I'm not really sure where I'm going to mount it yet, so I don't think we're going to drill the holes.
Oh, okay. You can drill
them. I think we'll leave them because I got a log home.
Oh.
And
well, once you sometimes get it mounted, you have to really love a picture of it.
Yeah. You have to be careful where you. You know, you want to catch the logs are about 12 inches, so.
Yeah, you want to catch them low, Al.
Yeah.
You want to get the hole in the right location.
Yeah. This some of his work.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Wow, even the bench is all flame cut.
Oh, yes.
How much you charge for one of your benches?
5 1/4.
5 1/4. Remember that, folks. You want a really nice bench.
Okay, so now I'll reload.
I'm presuming this thing's pretty loud, is it?
It is. Yeah, it'll be loud once we get it going. It's very quiet now. Why didn't that read? There we go. The angle, we didn't move the machine, so we're still good.
How long do you think it'll take to cut?
5-10 minutes.
That's all?
It shouldn't take that long.
So I should, I've got about, I think about, oh, I can do 50 minutes.
50 minutes? Oh, you got lots of time.
Yeah.
Okay, so act, no, zoom. I want to just double check that O again. There we go. Now you can see the difference.
Yeah.
So the lead in is here, it goes in, and then it'll stop.
Carries right through, yeah. So your lead-in then is in the middle of the...
On some things, some of them don't. I just give it a quarter or an eighth circle.
Yep.
And the red line right here, this would be my lead-in. And it cuts, goes around,
yep.
And then comes back out.
Excellent.
All right.
Are we ready? We set her up?
You can set her up.
Okay. You're good. We'll be right back. That is amazing.
You got the skills, Ed. Now let's clean it up and put it together.
That'll make visitors ask questions. I have a walkway. It's 33 feet long. It stands 16 feet tall. And it's seven hammer beam trusses.
Oh my.
All out of big timber.
Wow.
And 12 pillars. And then cement piers that the are around the pillars and everything. I spent a year building the darn thing, and it gets a lot of people's attention, I'll tell you. It's all representative of the Book of Revelation.
Really?
That's what it's all about. So when you...
I'd love to go see that.
Oh, movie. You're more than welcome to come out, and I'll give you the grand tour.
Where are you living?
Twin Lakes Road.
Okay.
Do you know where the gun club is?
Yes.
I'm just before the gun club. I'm a half a mile east of the gun club. There's two big gospel text signs, 10 feet by 5 feet, out at the front. You shouldn't be able to miss that. You have to come in about a quarter of a mile.
All right.
Just follow the main lane.
It's going to get loud a little bit there?
Yep.
Make this fit into the grooves.
Is this for someone like in a room divider or something or what?
No, it's going to be rolled into a fire pit.
Oh, yes.
And that's the bad side. I'll flip it around to the good side.
No. That's good. That's good. I like moose. I have a...
Oh, yeah?
And there you go.
Thank you very, very much.
You waited so long for it. I hope you love it.
Very nice. Do you want to tell me who you are?
Okay.
You stand there. I'm going to back up a little bit.
I'm going to put this here.
Sure. And what's your business, your email, or how to get in touch with you?
My name is Joe Dubé. I'm also known as Plasma Joe. I've been doing this for over 25 years. Started with a hand torch, oxy-fuel, doing ornamental art. And then from working in steel trades, moved up to automated tables, camera eyes, and now CNCs. My company name is Profile Plus Metal Arts. Been in business for about 10 years now, total. You can get a hold of me through Facebook. Just go in your search bar and punch in Profile Plus Metal Arts, and I'll give you one of my business cards if you put on your video, so you get the correct spelling, and go right to my site. There's thousands of examples of different works I've done there. You can also contact me by email at joedubé@eastlink.ca or by telephone 705-648-4900. Thanks very much, Ed.
Excellent. And he's a Christian brother to boot.
Yes.
Beat that.